If you are not within the stadium, you will be asked to leave. In compliance with state law, there is no smoking or vaping or possession of alcoholic beverages allowed on school grounds. We ask for and appreciate your cooperation with this. You will be removed from the premises if you violate this law. We'd like to take this opportunity to inform you that the officials for tonight's contest have been assigned by the host school and approved by both schools and the IHSA. Our officials tonight are Bobby Hensley, John Wren, Tim Feiden, and Albert Hampton. The village of Dwight wants all DTHS and GSW student athletes to have successful seasons and a strong school year. They say, Trojans, you make us proud. And you can follow Mother Road to great food and service at Old Route 66 Family Restaurant. They're open every day, serving the community for over 20 years. You can enjoy the homemade soups, specials, and a full menu, and you'll be glad that you did. BT Plumbing, Heating, and Cooling wants to thank the community for all the support they have given him, and in turn, he isn't letting his money go down the drain. In fact, he's supporting the Trojans in all their athletic endeavors. Attitude is everything, Trojans. Best of luck for a good season from your friends at United Meters. And best of luck to the DTHS GSW Trojans from your friends at Dwight Bank, a branch of Bank of Pontiac. Stop in and see them for your banking needs. Dwight Township High School would like to thank Morris Hospital and the Morris Orthopedic Office, especially our athletic trainer Laura Pittenger, for providing DTHS with outstanding athletic training services. The Dwight Banking Center of People's National Bank is proud to support our DTHS student athletes, and you can show your support too with their Dwight Township Trojan debit cards and checks. Thanks to the Dwight Sports Boosters for all the work they do in assisting the sports programs at Dwight Township High School. Fight on, Trojans. And if you direct your attention to midfield, where we're having the captain's meeting and the coin flip. Indication is that the Trojans will receive to open the game.
Yeah.
kick up the middle, fielded by Dylan Crouch. He'll advance the ball out to the 39-yard line. We'll take over first and take the 39. Hand off goes to David Page Gomez ahead. There is a flag at the line of scrimmage. Encroachment against the Trojans will be a 5-yard walk off. We will have first and 15. Carry to the left by Caden Nelson, tripped up by a Blue Devil tackler in the backfield. That looked to be number 35. Quarterback Evan Cox takes the ball to the right end, tackled after a short gain. Bring up 3rd and 13 for Dwight. Aiden Roth with the carry. He'll pick up 2 and we'll have 4th and 11. Angel Martin with a 37-yard punt for the Trojans. Blue Devils take over 1st and 10 on their 31-yard line. scramble by quarterback Eli McConkie around the right end. He makes it to the 50-yard line. That is a first and 10 on an 18-yard scramble. Complete to Gene Kolumnik. He takes the ball down inside the 5-yard line. There is a flag on the play. Joey starts with the stop. Being waved off, and the ball will be spotted at the 4-yard line for Bismarck-Henning. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a black Ford pickup truck. It's a 4x4 F-150 that needs to be moved, license plate 287-5548. We need to move that so we can get the ambulance in. Carry by Lucas Cade to the right stop at the 1-yard line. McConkie completes his pass to number 25. Good for a 1-yard touchdown score with 3:51 remaining in the first quarter. Flag on the play. Indication is encroachment against Dwight. The kick is blocked. That was Dylan Crouch with the block, and the score will hold 6-0, 3:51 left in the first quarter. Again, if you're the owner of a black F-150 pickup truck with license plate 287-5548, we need you to move your vehicle. That's been moved, thank you. Hand off to David Page Gomez. Stop at the line of scrimmage, and we will have a 6-6 tie, 3:37 in the first quarter. Kick off for Dwight GSW. Ball fielded by number 5, King Lumnick. That's a 30, is tackled at the 35-yard line. Brought down by Jackson Longus. Across the 45 or 46 yard line, and that is good for a first down. Actually spotted on the 47 yard line.
All right, come on, Trojan, hold up!
line of scrimmage, maybe a short loss. Gary made it back to the line of scrimmage before being stopped, so we'll have second and 10. Flag at the line of scrimmage. That is a false start. On the Blue Devils will be a 5-yard walk-off. We'll repeat second down. It'll be second and 15. Completed to number 21, tackled after a gain of 6, ball spotted at the 48-yard line. Bring up 3rd and 9. Advance the ball out to the 49-yard line. It'll be 4th and 6. Timeout, Bismarck-Henning. Indication is encroachment on the Trojans. That'll walk off 5 yards and we'll have 4th and about a yard. And off to number 25. First tackler there for the Trojans is Evan Cox. Ball will be spotted at the 38-yard line, first and 10 for Blue Devils. Pass is completed to number 5. Flag at the point of the play. Indication is offensive pass interference, so wipe out the play. Ladies and gentlemen, the concession stand is open. They have hot dogs, candy, popcorn, water, chip, all kinds of things for you to enjoy this evening, so stop by the concession stand when you get a chance. With that offensive penalty at the end of the quarter. Need an indication if this is an on-time down. Okay, that's our ball, number 21. Tackled by number 30, Alex Rogue. No flag on the play, and that will bring us to the end of the quarter. To get adjusted to reflect it as being 2nd and 21 on this play. Up the middle stop by Landon Burkhart and several other Trojan tacklers. Gain of 1 will spot the ball at the 47. We'll have about 3rd and 20. Thank you. pass downfield in and out of the hands of the receiver. Falls incomplete. Will bring up fourth down and 20. For correction, our previous tackle was by Ethan Snappa. Timeout by the Trojans. Carry by David Page Gomez. He will take the ball out across the 35 to the 38-yard line. Gain of 5 will bring up second and 5. Bring up 35. Dwight carry by number 5, Caden Nelson. There's a flag at the end of the play. Ball's being spotted at the 43-yard line. Thank you. indication is unsportsmanlike conduct against the Trojans. Be a 15-yard walk-off from the end of the play. And we'll have third and 15. Correction. The original carry had given the Trojans a first down. The unsportsmanlike penalty is a dead ball foul. He moved back 15 yards. And then they'll spot in and we'll have first and 10. Carry by Paige Gomez. Gets it out to the 31-yard line. Game of three will have second and seven. Nelson goes around the left end, looking for a spot at looks to be the 38-yard line. Paige Gomez, his ball ahead, looks to be a yard. It's a 39-yard line. Second and 9 for the Trojans. Gomez off the right tackle across the 45 to the 47-yard line will bring up third and 1. Gomez carries the ball ahead. Ball spotted on the 49-yard line, and it is a great first down. Getting Nelson looking to the right side, escapes the tackler, looks to get back to the line of scrimmage. Timeout by Bismarck-Henning. Second and 9 for the Trojans. Flag comes out to stop the play. Offsides against the Trojans. It'll be a 5-yard walk off. We will replay second down, this time 2nd and 14. By Aiden Robb. They'll take the ball to the 48-yard line. Timeout by Bismarck-Henning. We will turn with 3rd and 11. Evan Cox keeps the ball, goes around the left end, fights his way out across midfield to the 49-yard line. Bring up 4th down and 8. Angel Martin kicks the ball and will roll down at the 25-yard line. 24-yard punt for Angel Martin. Blue Devils take over first and 10 on their 25-yard line. The attempt falls outside the reach of the receiver, Caden Klemnick. Bring up second and 10. Pass complete to number 21. He will take the ball out almost to the 40. There is a flag late in the play. Indication looks to be the block in the back. The Blue Devils will walk off 10. We'll replay second down. Attempt goes to a group at the 42-yard line, falls incomplete, and we'll have third down at 7. Pass attempt to number 5 falls incomplete and bring up 4th down. quick ball go over on downs to Dwight GSW with 12.9 remaining in the half. Indication is holding against the Trojans. Out by the Trojans. It's a scramble under pressure brought down, and that will take us to the end of the first half. We are tied 6-6. Well, it's now be a great time to visit the concession stand. You're going to find water, soda, popcorn, candy, hot dogs, and chips for your halftime meal. So visit the DTHS concession stand. Load up so that you're ready for an exciting second half of Trojan football.
Thank you.
onside kickoff covered by number 57. Ball's going to be spotted at the 48-yard line, first and 10 for the Blue Devils. Hand off to number 19, tackled near the line of scrimmage by Dylan Crouch, brought down for no gain. It'll be second and 10. Outside, tackled by number 24, McKay Leeson of the Trojans. Ball's at the 47-yard line, the third and 5. Quarterback keeps the ball around the left end, goes out of bounds near the 40-yard line. He'll pick up a first down for Bismarck-Henning. By number 19, tackled just past the line of scrimmage, pick up a 2. Dylan Crouch leading the charge for the Trojans defense. Assisted by Jackson Lawrence, will have 2nd and 8. Here by number 25, tackled by Aiden Roth. Roth here got to the 34-yard line and will have 3rd and 4. Well, carries the ball outside, cracked down by the Trojan defense. Ultimately stopped by Xander Tarnowski. Bring up 4th and 4. Pass complete to number 25. He's down at the 20-yard line. Tackle was by Aiden Roth. Ball spotted right at the 20, and it'd be 1st and 10 for the Blue Devils.
Come on, Trojans, hold up!
made by number 12 to the right tackle. Gain of 5 will bring up 2nd and 5. Start against Bismarck-Henning. There'll be a 5-yard walk off the replay. 2nd down, it'll be 2nd and 10. Completes the ball to, that is, Thomas Anderson, complete to Caden Kolumnik. Good for a Bismarck-Henning touchdown, 3-12 in the third quarter. Number 12 goes outside and in for the 2-point conversion that will stretch the Blue Devil lead to 14-6. Offsides against the Blue Devils, a 5-yard walk-off. Goes out of bounds. Trojans will look to make a decision on where they get caught. Ball went out of bounds at the 42, so that is where they will take the ball, first and 10. There's no penalty on the play. And he's going to slot the ball at the 33-yard line. 25-yard carry for Caden Nelson. And that is a first down Trojan. Gomez takes the ball ahead. Ball's going to be spotted at the 31-yard line with the gain of 3. Ahead across the 25. Ball's going to be at the 24, and that is a first down, Trojan. David Page Gomez inside the 20 down to the 15-yard line. We'll have second and one. Takes the ball ahead to the 6-yard line. First down, Trojan. Nelson with the carry. Ball came loose near the goal line, waiting for a ruling. Yeah. indication is the runner was fouled by contact. It will be second and goal from the one. Carry by David Page Gomez in for a 1 yard curling touchdown. To Paige Gomez, stop. The 2-point conversion is no good. The 13.4 remaining in the third quarter. Dwight pulls within two, 14 to 12. Martins onside kick bounces over receiver Riley, covered at looks to be the 33 yard line. Number 25 takes the ball off right tackle, gets outside and brought down. Looks to be about the 38 yard line. And that will take us to the end of the third quarter. Bismarck-Henning Blue Devils 14, Dwight GSW Trojans 12. I want to be a lawyer. Dwight bye week, we'd like to thank Coach Sandiford for picking Saquon Barkley in the third round. Okay, this is the right side by number 17 with the turns and tacklers there. Evan Cox leading the way. Looks to be a gain of about one on the play. We'll have third and five. By number 9. Ball's going to be spotted at the 44-yard line, good for a Blue Devil first down. Yes, number 9 for the Blue Devils takes the ball behind his blockers and will get across the 50 down to the 45, and that is another first down. By Aiden Roth of the Trojans. Ball spotted at the 38 will bring up second and 3. Number 9 up the middle. Tackle was by Joey Starks. Ball's gonna be spotted at the 26, and that'll be another first down for Bismarck-Henning. Trojan defense with a stand. Jackson Lanius leading the way. Gain of about a yard. Be right on the 25-yard line, bring up second and 9. Thank you. Ball spotted around the 21, 22 yard line. We'll bring up third down and 5. Pass completed, number 25, tackled by Aiden Roth. Ball's going to be spotted on the 17 and bring up fourth down and 1. Pass complete, number 25, who picked up blockers downfield and will go in for a 17-yard touchdown for Bismarck-Henning, with 2:56 remaining in the game. Bismarck-Henning. Be a 5-yard walk-off and we will retry the PAT. Timeout, Dwight. Defended and in and out of hands, the receiver falls incomplete. That will leave the lead at 8 with 2:56 remaining in the fourth quarter. Indication is this ball will belong to the Trojans. Ball spotted on the 46-yard line, first and 10 for Dwight GSW. Left by number 24, Aiden Roth, takes the ball inside the 25 to be spotted at the 24-yard line. Well, second and 6. About Dwight. Trojans come out of the timeout, second and 6. Halfback pass is intercepted in the end zone, and that will be a touchback for Bismarck-Henning. Evan Cox breaks through and makes a tackle at or behind the line of scrimmage. Looks like it is right at the 20-yard line, so no gain on the play. It'll be second and 10. Fans, as you leave tonight, please grab your garbage and drop it in one of our garbage cans on your way out. We appreciate your assistance with getting everything cleaned up. It makes everything a lot easier for the crew after the game. If you can take all of your garbage, your popcorn bags, your bottles, your hot dog wrappers, and all that. By number 9 goes outside, tackled by Aiden Roth. Carried by number 17 to the right, brought down at the 20-yard line. And that will take us to the end of the game. Let's give both teams a round of applause for a hard-fought VGC crossover game. Congratulations to the Bismarck-Henning Blue Devils on their victory. Fans, thank you for coming out tonight. We hope that the fans from Bismarck-Henning have a pleasant and safe drive home. We made that drive on Saturday. And we look forward to seeing fans of Trojan Athletics back here on Friday as your Dwight PSW Trojans start their home season hosting Westville with the varsity kickoff at 7 p.m.
If there's something we gotta do and you think it's a thing to do, let me know. I'm just gonna have to. I'm going.